The first Earth Day was 50 years ago. On that day, something like 10% of the US population went out to protest in favor of environmental reform. Since then, we've had enormous impacts on the planet, but we've also made amazing steps towards saving the world. So let's look at those 50 years of improvements and see why we might be optimistic about the future of the planet. This video is brought to you by the Rainbow of Birds ebook. More on that later. Fuel economy. In 1975, the first fuel economy standards were set, with the goal of raising the terrible fuel economy of passenger vehicles. When they went into place, the average fuel economy for passenger cars was 14 miles per gallon. Average. That means that some vehicles were higher and some were lower than 14 miles per gallon. Their goal was to raise that average fuel economy, and they did. The most efficient new cars now get 30 plus miles per gallon. New hybrids get up into the 50 plus miles per gallon range. And electric cars? Well, they had to make their own scale because they don't use internal fuel. But if you compare energy content directly, electric cars right now go 100 plus miles on the amount of energy in 1 gallon of gas. With the advent of mass-market electric cars, we now have new ways to improve our energy efficiency. Because now, we can improve the efficiency of power generation, transmission, and also the electric motors in the car. Fuel economy is about to take even bigger leaps going forwards. This is so exciting! We've made so much progress over the last 50 years. Bald eagles. In 1939, we discovered a new, incredibly effective insecticide called DDT. It killed mosquitoes, it killed crop pests, it killed lice, and it didn't immediately poison people. Was there no downside at all? Should we spray it on our forests? Yes! Should we spray it down our shirts? Why not? Should we spray it on the beach and let children play in the fog? After all, it's harmless to humans, so let them play! Well, it turned out that there were downsides. It might cause cancer for one thing, possible reproductive problems in humans, and definite reproductive problems in birds of prey. DDT made eggshells thin enough that they cracked in the nest. The bald eagle population went from 400,000 to less than 10,000. DDT was banned in 1972, and within 10 years, the population went from 10,000 to 100,000. They are no longer endangered and have been removed from the endangered species list. We did it! We saved the bald eagle! Good job, everyone! Protected areas. The United States has about 285 million square miles of protected land, adding up national parks, private conserved land, etc. The United States has protected about 95,000 square miles of land in the last 30 years, or to put it another way, about 2.5% of its total land area. There has been a long history of conservation leadership in the US, and this is an area where the government is doing pretty well. They're making slow, incremental progress over a period of decades towards a really worthwhile goal. The United States has also protected about 25% of its territorial waters since the year 2000. Before that, there were basically no protected areas for ocean ecosystems. Add all those up, and the United States is protecting 14% of its land area and 26% of its territorial waters. Look how far we have come! The rest of the world has been doing the same. There are now about 8 million square miles of protected land worldwide. To put it in perspective, this is slightly more land than is in all of North America, set aside so that animals and plants can live their lives with less disturbance. Keep up the good work, humanity. Renewable energy is one of the brightest stars in environmental hope these days. This is technology like solar cells, wind turbines, and geothermal systems that can generate electricity from renewable sources. For a long time, it was more expensive to get electricity from these renewable sources than from fossil fuels, which isn't surprising because most of the renewable technologies were new, and we have over 100 years of infrastructure and expertise in pulling oil, gas, and coal out of the ground.
But a 2019 report found that building and running large wind and solar generating plants cost about the same as running an existing coal-fired power plant without any subsidies. I'll tell you the caveats in a second, but think what that means. If the electricity market can save money by building solar farms, nothing will stop them from doing it. Saving the planet is a nice side effect to increased profitability. This is the area I'm most excited about because I think there will be a tipping point where renewable energy makes more sense than fossil energy. And then that same brilliance that went into fossil energy will go to vastly better long-term uses, creating relatively clean energy as a platform for the next 100 years. Okay, caveat time. This number assumes all electricity is equal when renewables and fossil fuels generate power differently. Solar power, for example, works best when the sun is out and worst at night. But at some price point, it makes sense to build all the renewable power that you can and deal with the problems of generation using the same problem-solving, profit-seeking ability we use for fossil fuel generation. India and China have installed the 8 largest solar generating stations in the world, and they did it in the last 5 years. Clearly, they thought the benefits outweighed the cost.
With so many successes over the last 50 years, it's hard to imagine why we're having trouble facing the challenges of the next 50 years. But if we apply the same decisiveness and long-term thinking, we can make positive changes that will affect the world for generations to come. So let's change things for the better. Conservation is easiest when people care about animals. To see the beauty of birds and why we might care about saving them, check out the Rainbow of Birds ebook. I wrote it to connect people with birds, and I promise you'll learn something worth knowing from it. Just go to biobush.tv/rainbow. Thanks for taking the time to look at our accomplishments since the first Earth Day. There are other conservation-themed videos on this channel, and you can subscribe to know when a new video comes out. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.